the very unlikely event of any emergency, you'll be notified by means of an announcement. Now please remain calm and comply with all directions given by myself and the crew. Now emergency exits on board, you can see the small green and white signs all over, and these are your signs. We've also got an additional few life-saving apparatus just down the side. They can be manually launched or float free if required. Now in the interest of safety, will adults please ensure that small children are accompanied at all times and not left alone on any part of this vessel. And due to current legislation, the whole of the vessel is classified as non-smoking. Okay, so we've got two toilets on board. We've got one upstairs as you enter the upper saloon, just to your right-hand side, and the other one is just downstairs, opposite the boarding steps at the rear of the boat. And if you do go downstairs and go into the lower saloon, you'll find a bar around the corner to the left-hand side, serving a selection of hot and cold drinks, a bit of alcohol, if you're old enough and behave on board, of course. Also a few crisp cakes, chocolates, things like that. So go and see Donna about 10 minutes after we depart. I'll let you know over the PA when that's open as well. So thank you very much for listening, and we'll shortly get underway. Good afternoon once again, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the start of our hour and a half trip on the beautiful Norfolk Broads. As you'll see, it's such a lovely sunny day still, so hopefully we'll see plenty of wildlife as we make our way along. I'd like to talk to you as we go through the village of Hobbiton St John on the left-hand side, Wroxham on the right, as we go on to Wroxham Broad, a very big, large, popular sailing broad, and then even on to Salhouse Broad, which is slightly smaller, a bit more wildlife on Salhouse Broad. So I'd like to talk to you on this trip, especially on the outward journey, about the history, the wildlife, the origins, anything we really see out here today. It's pretty much just to see what we go. I mean, there's no script. We'll just do what we can with what we have out here. When we turn around, by the way, at Salhouse Broad, I will remain fairly quiet on the return journey. So at least you can enjoy this area in a bit of peace and quiet without me going on in your ear. When it comes to us especially, we've just left one of the oldest boatyards on the Norfolk Broads. Now this has been extensively modernised in recent years thanks to a gentleman called John Loynes. Now this came about because John Loynes, he took a few of his friends around the Broads in his 14-foot rowing dinghies. Now when they were quite keen bird watchers back then, they wanted to keep stopping while they went along the beautiful rivers with John. And John Loynes is quite an impatient man, so he wanted to keep going. Now finally, one of his friends asked him, why can't we just hire the boat from you? So at least we can please ourselves where we go. And that's where the actual concept of boat hire was born. Now seeing the potential for holiday boating, he built a selection of cruising boats especially suited for the Broads. They charge £1.10 to up to £2.50 a week for a boat without attendance, and 3 to 4 guineas with attendance. Now Loynes, he originally operated this business in Norwich, and it soon became clear that a more natural location would be here in Wroxham, but with these small, easy to handle yachts, it paved the way for the modern sort of self-drive cruiser industry that we know today. But when it comes to our company and our very boat charge, we were started up in 1930. You know, some general facts about the Broads, like the depth of the water, for example. Don't hesitate to ask, just come and give me a knock on the door, or ask Donna. Donna can always relay the information. We've got a little telephone between us, so she can always contact me. So yeah, just ask Donna. I'm quite happy to answer just whatever about the Broads we may have. A couple of beautiful thatched properties in particular, which recently come off for sale only over the last couple of days. I'm not quite sure on the price of that one, but I do have a good idea on what the other houses around here. So, as we do come down this side, on the right, we've got a couple of beautiful weeping willow trees. And between that, you've got a long straight garden and a white fronted house down the end. So, just about another touch, so people who remember him, who owned this house back in the 40s and 50s, can have a quick look. So, if you remember an old ukulele player and entertainer, Mr. George Formby, he used to live by, he used to spend a lot of holidays down here. That comes in this visible, you'll see a white fronted house with a lot of geese, just keeping that grass nice and short for them, just down there to the right. So George and Beryl for me. Love the Broads. They kept coming back here at least every single year, if not a couple of times every year. Now, they were Northerners. There's a bit of a struggle down here to escape from all of their adoring fans. So, George and Beryl, they spent a lot of time around the Broads on their three boats, the Nadine Beryl 1, 2, and 3, all named respectively after his lovely wife, Beryl. Even the house was called Beryl, Beryldine, so you can imagine she definitely wore the trousers. Nice Halloween themed garden here on the right. In fact, in the garden, you can see three Egyptian geese. So, Egyptian geese here on the right hand side look similar to greylags, but bigger in the garden in most cases to protect them from flood damage. Because anything connected to the sea always has a chance of flooding every now and again. So every sort of 15, 20 years on an average, you usually get high tides that coincide with heavy rainfalls, strong onshore winds. Even when it's during the winter, this can always bring in a little bit extra water. Now when this happens, it can sort of flood this area. Usually can just about get into the gardens. You can imagine how high the water is at that point. So it goes over the key heading, floods the gardens. Oh, and in this garden, we have a grey heron actually, just here to your right-hand side, worth having a look at. Was blending in nicely. So a grey heron now level with the front of the boat. Just having a look in the garden there. Now usually they hunt in the water, so I don't know what it's doing in there. Maybe fancies a few insects instead. So grey heron or a Hansa or the old Frank just there to your right hand. It's called a Hansa, by the way, because that's a Norfolk word for tall and thin. A bit like myself. Probably not.